the other end of the ice, a lot of pressure, obviously, on Nikolai Haby-Boulin coming into this game. He said after game one that he had a hard time focusing on pucks through traffic. He couldn't find them. Early in this game, I thought he moved side to side extremely well. Calgary's putting bodies in front. But the last two saves that he made, and I know you guys have mentioned, not overly tested, but he's sucking up the rebounds like we saw in that Philadelphia series.
John Tortorella told us before that Philadelphia series, you can tell whether or not Haby-Boulin's going to be on right away, whether he sees the puck or doesn't. He says the nights he can't see the puck, it is evident, and it does not recover from it.
Well, in game one, his chest was like a trampoline. The puck would hit his chest and bounce right back out. In this game here, and Darren said it perfectly, he has sucked the puck in, almost like a Pac-Man game. The puck stays with him, it doesn't rebound, and it kills the play every time.
See, all you need is that great big layer of Velcro on the outside of your jersey, then you put a little on the outside of the puck. It's like the Velcro wall. It's like jumping into a Velcro wall.
Make it stick. Haby-Boulin, just the second goaltender from the former Soviet Union to be in the Stanley Cup Finals. Archer's Urbe, 2002 with Carolina.
Now, Urbe, you want to make sure you say the proper thing, and that is he's from Latvia.
Latvia.
Which was the part of the former
USSR. That's exactly right. Third back in, looking St. Louis was in front. Pass got blocked, Regier. Hit put on by Simon. Turn around, Regier. Regier double teamed. Didn't want St. Louis to handle that. He was behind him on the other side. Long clearing pass. Haby-Boulin's going to come up and play this. Haby-Boulin clears it off the near side. Boards. Rebound chance. Haby-Boulin with a save.
What shot from Supreme.
Just came up, and that puck came right to it. Nobody picked him up as he came into the zone. Intended for Simon, who does get it. His shot, that got partially blocked out there. Picked up by LeCavalier. LeCavalier leaves it. Big back-checking job as it's Lukowicz trying to flip it in, but it goes up and into the seats. Want to remind you, tomorrow night, ESPN's exclusive coverage just for the NBA, beginning with the Kia NBA shoot-around at 7:30. At 8, Jermaine O'Neal, Indiana Pacers, trying evil it against Ben Wallace and the Pistons. Also available in ESPN HD. That's tomorrow night, NBA. Certainly are delighted to have you with us. Game two, Stanley Cup Finals. Upstairs, Gary Thorne, Bill Clement, John Davidson here in Tampa Bay, as we will be in Canada, good Lord willing, on Saturday night. Calgary Flames will take the series back home. On the near sideboards flip, question is, will Calgary be up 2-0? Will Tampa Bay win this game and even it up? Jumped in by Billy Neiman into the corner. Almost clearly back in behind the net. Wow. Shoots it off the glass. Look where that one came. Center break from Tampa Bay to get it out of there. Right back in, 2-on-2, Billy Niemann heading to the net. Looking for him, shot deflected. Niemann charging in on Haby-Boulin. Pretty good setup right there by Nielsen. He's got to get out of the zone. Niemann does. He's just not clearing, and that's offside.
I think they're calling it an intentional offside, too.
Watt tried to throw the big hit on Nielsen, who was dinged in game one by Corey Stillman. I think he's playing with a foggy head, yet he's playing very well. Here's Nielsen with a pass in front. And the back checking of Cullimore made the play. Niemann was driving to the net.
That went off the heel of Cullimore's stick. Ooh, otherwise, it was right on Niemann's tape. But that's what I meant when I say Calgary's coming. They're developing chances just like that. But against Tampa Bay, you can play that way, and you can still lose because they're so high-powered with their counterattack.
Isn't it just strange you say Calgary's better 5-on-5, and you think about 5-on-5? Calgary's had all the power plays. So we're saying they're a better team 5-on-5 than what they are when they have a power play.
Maybe a hit 4-1.
Odine got it back into the middle. Kubina got knocked down. Claire Conroy, who didn't have a stick, let it go by. And it's moved out of there by Jordan Leopold. Played back by Sidor. Ooh, Sidor turned right into that check by Jelena. Jelena went flying. Sidor trying to clear it up. Conroy takes the hit up high. It'll be moved out by Tampa Bay to Richards. Richards, who had a breakaway earlier, brings it into the zone. Odine could not get to it. Richards got it back down low, 2-on-1. Shot! Bounced up in the air and kept himself going. Good one underway, game two, lightning up.